Hello everyone. Today I'm going to speak about contract. What is contract? In business law, contract is a very important topic. On this basis, we are going to discuss a lot of concepts. So you must have a clear idea about this contract. So as per this Contract Act 1872, Indian Contract Act, Section 2, Subsection H, it says that a contract is an agreement between two or more than two parties which can be enforceable into the law. So that is called as contract. In detail, if you want to see, two or more than two parties want to do something or want to obstruct something, want to do or want to abstain something. So for that purpose, when they are entering into any agreement, that agreement can be enforceable into the court of law. So that is called as contract. So contract is having a lot of features. So this is very important topic. All the features we are going to discuss in detail, and each and every feature is going to be a very big concept, a very big topic. In future we are going to discuss in detail. So right now we'll see the contract features. The contract first feature is that proposal. Before going to proposal, what is contract? Make it very clear. Contract means agreement plus enforceability. Only two words are there. Contract means agreement plus enforceability. For example, two parties made an agreement that wanted to sell the property and another person wanted to purchase the property. So when this agreement can be enforceable into the court of law, then this will become a contract. Yes, it is enforceable. Both the parties are having the capacity, both are agreeing together without any force, then this is a contract. Suppose say A is saying another party, B, to go and break the head of C. It's a murder. Agreement is there. Proposal, proposee. Both are there. Agreement is there. But it cannot be enforced into the court of law because it is illegal. It cannot be enforced. So that will not become a contract. So simple formula is contract means agreement plus enforceable into the court of law. Agreement plus enforceability, both will make a contract. Contract first feature is proposal. What is this proposal? Proposal is the initial stage of contract. When one person is feeling that I want to enter into the contract with someone. So that's the first step. A person who is proposing, who kept the proposal, that person is called as promiser, offerer, anything you can say, promiser, offerer. To whom he is proposing, that person will become promisee or offeree. So this is the first stage. But remember this, when proposal is kept by any person, so that should be free consent, no force, willingfully and having all the capacity, want to enter into the contract, then only that will become a valid proposal. And a proposal should not be like simply giving a gesture or saying yes to any kind of contract, not officially not saying anything, silently nodding the head. This will not become a contract. For example, A asked B, will you sell your flat? B nodded his head. But at what rate he wanted to sell, to whom he wanted to sell, when he wanted to sell, no details are given. That will not become a contract. Proposal is there, but acceptance is not proper. That is why it must be clearly mentioned, then only it will become a valid proposal. This is first one is that proposal. Then after that, acceptance. When promissory is proposing to someone, then a person to whom he proposed, that person will become the promisee. So that person has to give the acceptance. That's the second feature. Acceptance must be given by the promisee. When he has to be, as per the given date, as per the agreement, and as per the conditions, as per the talk, that promisee has to give the acceptance. But remember, when promisee has to give the acceptance, no condition. There should not be any condition. If he kept any condition, that contract will become invalid. Condition should not be there. And bargain also. There should not be any kind of bargain. A kept one amount and B also has to accept. When B is bargaining, then A has to agree for the same thing. Otherwise, it will not become a valid contract. In the same way, there should not be any third party accepting it. So that is, acceptance is given by third party. It will not become a contract. Only the proposal means first party, second party. In between these two parties only, the contract has to form. For example, A asked B 50,000 of loan. B did not say anything, but C is ready to give the loan to A. See, A, B, C. A asked B 50,000 of loan. B did not say anything. Now C is ready to give to the A. That will not become contract. In fact, the contract is between A and B only. So C is entering in between A and B. So that will not become a contract. No third party. Only two parties must be there. So that's about the acceptance. And the third very important thing is that consideration. Third feature. Consideration means for any kind of transaction, for any kind of acceptance or proposal, there should be a solid consideration, a solid fruitful something must be there, either in the money form or in the service form. Something consideration is needed. If no consideration, that will not become a contract. That is what saying by the why quid pro quo. Quid pro quo means it is a Latin word. So this word is saying no consideration, no contract. Means consideration is compulsory. A small example I'll give you. A wanted to give a donation of 1 lakh rupees to a charitable trust. Only donation he wanted to give. But due to unavoidable circumstances, A could not give the donation of 1 lakh rupee to the charitable trust. Charitable trust sued on A. Is the charitable trust is going to win the case? No, because A just wanted to give a donation. There is no consideration for A. If consideration is there, then that will become a solid contract. Otherwise, this is quid pro quo. As per this will become invalid. So that is not acceptable. That will not become a full contract. So that's about the consideration. Then after that, capacity of parties. Whenever a proposal kept propose or kept any kind of agreement in front of promisee, that both of them should have the capacity to perform the contract. Say A wanted to sell his property or sell one of his flat. B is ready to purchase it, but B is in a financially sound position, or that is very important. If he is in a position to purchase it, then that will become a contract. And there are a few cases which we can say that this capacity of the party is not going to be considered. There is no capacity. In which cases? First one is minor. Minor means a person whose age is below 18 years. Below 18 years is minor. So if minor, any kind of contract if you make, that will become invalid as per the void ab initio. This is very important, please remember. Void ab initio is saying that contract with any minor below 18 years, it will become invalid. So that is why don't make any kind of contracts with minors. And sound mind. Proposer and proposee. Offerer or offeree, promiser or promisee, both the parties should have a sound mind. Any one party is lunatic, drunkard, idiot, any such kind of cases are there, that contract will become invalid. So that is why both the parties should have a sound mind. And third one is insolvent. Any one party should not be declared as insolvent. He cannot pay the amount back to the anyone, not in a position to perform or make the agreement to be valid. So any of such cases, either A or B, proposer or proposee, if anyone is becoming an insolvent, then that contract will become invalid. And in the same way, not disqualified from the contracting. any of the party should not be declared as a disqualified as per the law. Suppose a person went to the jail and imprisonment, and he is illegally proved and his name is registered in CBI or somewhere else, then he will be disqualified by entering into the any kind of contract. So that is about the disqualified. Total capacity of the parties are possible only due to four conditions. Whenever minor is not there, major, he must be major, and a party should have a sound mind and should not be insolvent and not disqualified from the contracting. Then only it is possible. And the fifth feature of contract is free consent. Free consent means without any force, and genuine and normal formal contract should be there. There should not be any kind of force. So for example, you can say free consent of the contract when this is not there. When coercion means forcefully someone is making you to enter into the contract, that is coercion. Coercion, for example, I can give you, say A is asking B to sign on his property, transferring all the properties. A is asking B to transfer his property on A's name. Otherwise, A is going to do any kind of harm, physical harm or non-physical, any kind of things which is going to made by A to the B. So this is coercion, giving a threat. So with this threat, when A is entering into the contract, B does not have any kind of option. So B also agreed. This is coercion. Due to coercion, if the contract is making, but still in future that will become invalid. So that is why coercion should not be there. And undue influence is also undue influence. See, for example, once a Swamiji says to another person that you transfer some of your property on my name so that you get moksha, you get solvency, something he said. Then B is agreed, but later he realized, then that will not become a contract. So that is why no undue influence and fraud, making a fraud, hiding the facts and conceding some kind of things, and any kind of fraud happens, that is also will become invalid. Fraud should not be there. Misinterpretation. Suppose say A said that I will sell my Maruti car. Maruti clearly he said, but later he wanted to sell another car. So this is misinterpretation. Exactly what he wanted to sell, the description should match with the execution of the contract. At the same time, same thing has to be done. No misinterpretation. When these four are not there, then we can say it's a free consent. Free consent is very important. Then after that, lawful object. Lawful object. A contract will become, agreement will become a contract when it is lawfully, no objection. Lawfully it can be executed. Then only it will become a contract. When it will become a lawful contract. So whenever there is no illegal aspects, illegal transactions like smuggling or any kind of goods which are objected by the government, restricted by the government, distributing some kind of drugs which are addicted by the youth, that kind of any kind of illegal activities will not be accepted by the law. This is illegal, immoral and opposed to the public policy. Any of these things are that is not acceptable by the government, that is illegally not acceptable, not valid. So lawful object should be there. Then agreement not declared as void. Agreement not declared as void means agreement should be acceptable as per the rules and regulations of the contract, as per the features of the contract. Say for example, A is having a tiffin center in main center of Mumbai. A is having tiffin center, and opposite to A, B wanted to start another tiffin center. When A is having a very good tiffin center and B is going to start the same kind of tiffin center, what will happen? It's a threat for A. A's business may come down. So what A said to B, don't start business, don't start the tiffin center. For that purpose, for not starting your business, for not starting this tuition center, I will give you 10 lakh rupees. B has taken the 10 lakh rupees but started tuition center. Then A went to the court law and A could not win the case because there is no such kind of contracts for stopping someone and for interrupting, for obstructing when it is legally acceptable, when he can open that business. So no one can do any kind of stoppable things or any kind of acceptance or all these things, not possible. That's the reason law is saying agreement should not be declared as void. It is acceptable. Next one, legal formalities. You know that in every contract we'll have two kinds of contract, oral contracts or written contracts. Oral or written contracts. So if you have this kind of oral or written contract, this is acceptable. And sometimes the contracts can be acceptable through only the gestures also. Everything is valid, but what law says is that oral or written or just by the gestures, if you are making any contract, that's okay, but always preferred and always recommended, suggested to go for written agreements only, written agreements. So that will be a proof, that will be a valid. If you, in future something happens, you can just go ahead with that witness. So that is why. What you need to do for such kind of written agreements, you have to take a court paper and stamp paper, the right amount of stamp paper, and both the parties, proposer and proposee, promisor and promisee, both the parties should sign and should draft it properly in a clear language, and they should sign end of the agreement, and also must be signed by the witnesses. Two adult witnesses must be signed, and it should be registered under the court. Then stamp paper and everything is there, then only it will become valid and solid contract. Otherwise legal formalities are not there, means anything may happen. That's the reason you should have a legal formalities. Total we have 8 features. What are the features? Simply need not to worry. This is a very important concept. Remember the concept. Side headings remember. Inside matter, if you know the concept, you can write it inside of the matter. And you know that if you want to give any examples, Mr. X, Mr. Y, Mr. P or Mr. ABC, like you can take any person and just describe. So that you can get inside matter also very solid with an example. In that way you can just go ahead. Now how many are there? Total 8 features. One is proposal. For any contract, proposal is compulsory. A person who is keeping a proposal is called as proposer or promiser, offerer. And who is accepting called as an offeree, promisee. So that acceptance, if both are there, my main two solid reasons or solid causes to enter into the contract. Then consideration, some fruitful thing is needed. Otherwise, it will become quid pro quo. Means no consideration, no contract. Then capacity of the parties. Parties should have a solid capacity. They should not be minor and they should have a sound mind, and they should not be declared as a contracting, and they should not be insolvent. Any of these cases are not there, then the party is ready to enter into the contract. So they are having the capacity to enter into the contract. In the same way, pre-consent. Any contractor or any contract must be with the pre-consent, without any force. So when it is possible, when there is no coercion, undue influence, fraud and misinterpretation, then it will become a free consent. And lawful object. Legally, illegal, immoral, opposed or public policy. Any of these things are not there, then that will become lawful object. And it should not be declared as void, just now as I gave the example. And legal formalities, if it is there, that's well and good. And the same concept, you may get an exam in another way also. All contracts are agreements. But not all agreements are contracts. Explain. Let me tell you, all contracts are agreements. Means when it is becoming a contract, agreement is there, enforceability is there, that will become a contract. But not all agreements are contracts. When it will become, agreement is there, any of these features are missing. 8 features, any feature is missing, then that cannot be enforceable into the court of law. That's the reason we say it as if all the contracts are agreements, but not all agreements are contracts. So what you need is just explain the concept of why all the agreements cannot be a contract. Explain a little bit, then after that speak about, write about this features of the contract. That will be a solid one. Do not get confused. Any kind of questions, they'll be asking in different way. So they are tilting the question. Answer is same. So stay tuned with me for more commerce and management talks. And any kind of doubts you can mention in the downside of the video. Please do suggest to commerce and management students about this channel. I'm going to come up with a lot of topics. Thank you for all your affection. Just go ahead, concentrate and focus. So I'll be coming shortly with a new concept.